Hi, my name is Maddy and I'm an instructor with Wordfence. Today, I'll be showing you what to do if you get locked out of your site using Wordfence. If you've been locked out of your site, you'll probably see a screen that looks like this. First, be sure Wordfence is the cause of the block. If so, you'll see the Wordfence logo at the bottom of the screen with a block reason listed. If this occurs, the first thing to take note of is what you were doing at the time the lockout happened, whether you had a typo in your username or logged in multiple times unsuccessfully. The first and easiest option to regain access to the site is to enter your email address and click Send Unlock Email. Once you've done that, you'll get an email with instructions on how to regain access to your website. So the email will look like this with unlock email requested as the email subject line. It'll come from your WordPress email and select the first option. Click here to unlock your ability to sign in and to access to the site. If the solution isn't working for you, another way to do this is to connect to another device with a different IP. So for this, we'll need to connect to VPN. This just allows you to use the same device you use to try to access your site, but with a different IP address. So once you connect to VPN, you can go back to the login of your site and attempt to log in. So here I'll show you logging into my VPN. It's connecting, and now it's connected, so I'm gonna refresh this page. I'm gonna add in my login credentials and attempt to gain access to the WordPress dashboard, which I was able to do. If you've successfully gained access, like I did, you'll navigate to Wordfence, Firewall, and then this blocking tab here. And so what you'll do next is scroll down to the bottom where you can see current blocks for your website, or in my case, bugfry.com. And you can take a look at the reason why this block occurred. In this case, I used an invalid username to try to sign in. And then at this point, we can also click to select these different block types and then unblock them. If you don't have access to VPN, you can use the same set of instructions on a mobile device using your wireless service. Just make sure you're not connected to Wi-Fi. If for any reason you don't see a current block, there's a chance that your block has expired. If either of these solutions don't work, or you get locked out again using the same credentials, there is another option, and that is by using an FTP client to deactivate Wordfence to gain access to your site. Here's how we'll do it. For this demo, I'm using FileZilla as my FTP client. You can also use File Manager. You'll want to first make sure that you've inputted your hostname, username, and password at the top of the client. Once there, we're going to try to access the WordPress root installation, which in this case is public_HTML. So once you're there, you can either double click or open with this arrow, and you're looking to find a couple folders. In this case, it's wp-admin, wp-content, and wp-includes. We are going to be looking specifically within the wp-content folder, which holds all the plugins. So again, we will open this folder, and then we're navigating down to the plugins folder and opening that. And in this folder, you'll be able to see all of the installed plugins from your WordPress website. And specifically, we want to navigate to the Wordfence folder. This is the most important step to troubleshoot the issues we're having. We're going to rename this folder to a different name, but just to be consistent, I'm going to go with Wordfence-temp. And so what'll happen now is this will deactivate Wordfence on the site completely. So we're going to go back to the website, and to test to see if this worked, I'm going to refresh this page that previously had a block. And now I have access to the login area again. So I'm going to go ahead and log in with my regular credentials. And with that, I've gained access to the site and it worked. So what's really important is to go back to your FTP client or file manager, whatever you used, and make sure that you go back and rename that folder from Wordfence-temp, or whatever you named it, back to just Wordfence. And so to make sure that that worked and Wordfence is reactivated on your website, we're going to refresh the page. You should now be seeing Wordfence on the left-hand side with your other plugins, and you'll be able to again go to that firewall and then blocking tab screen. And in this case, you'll see our last attempt to log in that blocked us. So I'm going to go ahead and click that and unblock it. If you're still seeing a black screen after you've reactivated the plugin by renaming the Wordfence folder back to Wordfence, consider deactivating the plugin again via your FTP client or file manager, and then installing and activating the Wordfence Assistant plugin, which is here. From that plugin, you can use the option to disable Wordfence firewall or clear all blocked out Wordfence IPs, blocked out users, and advanced blocks, and then proceed to rename the Wordfence plugin folder back to the original Wordfence name. At this point, you should no longer be blocked and be able to access the back end of the site with Wordfence enabled. Hopefully, these solutions allowed you to regain access to getting blocked out of your site. If for any reason you're still having trouble, please reach out to our support team. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to securing your WordPress website.